The daily horse care is very important. The horse's coat should always be kept clean to prevent accumulation of bacteria, and when riding the horse, prevent the horse from unpleasant rubbing spots through dirt underneath the saddle. But not only the back of the horse should be groomed. The head, the belly and legs should be cleaned as well. One rather typical consequence of careless grooming habits is, for example, cracked heel, a disease of the horse's legs due to mud inside the fetlock bend. Through proper grooming of the horse, diseases like that can be avoided. When grooming the horse, start with the currycomb. This type of brush is rather hard and should therefore only be used on body parts that are soft and muscular, not on the head or legs. The currycomb removes rough and chunky dirt. After the currycomb, we use the dandy or stiff brush. This brush is also used for rough dirt, but its bristles are softer so that it can be used on the legs. The next brush we use is the body brush. It has soft bristles and is used to brush off the dust and sand that is still left behind on the coat. To groom the horse's head, there's another special brush. This brush is often called smooch brush and has the same soft type of bristles as the body brush, but is smaller and easier to handle. Most horses really enjoy this brush.
Dem Pferd über die Nase bürstet, sondern mit so einer kleineren Bürste fühlt es sich dann auch wohler. Also den Striegel, den verwendet man in kreisförmigen Bewegungen.
Summing up. First, the currycomb is used with circular movement. Many horses like to be brushed like that along the neck. Remember this as a form of reward for good work in training or after a competition. Like mentioned before, make sure when brushing with the currycomb to groom areas on the horse's body that are soft and muscular.
Dass man jetzt zum Beispiel nicht hier vorne an der Schulter oder an dem Bein, wo halt viele knochige Stellen sind.
The horse's shoulders or legs should not be brushed with a currycomb, because the bristles are too hard and it would make the horse feel uncomfortable.
So, als zweites benutze ich jetzt die Wurzelbürste.
The dandy brush is used to remove chucky dirt and unwanted spots.
Zum Beispiel die Flecken wegzukriegen. Geh mal ein Stück vor.
When grooming young horses, always place one hand directly on the horse's body to prevent it from getting frightened of the brush. Body contact helps young horses to feel safe and to relax when being groomed.
Kontakt immer noch ein bisschen. Mit der Bürste kann ich jetzt auch die Beine putzen.
The dandy brush is soft enough to be used to clean the horse's legs. Mud and dirt can be removed from the legs. Don't forget the inside of the behind legs. This is where the horse sweats the most.
Wenn die geschwitzt haben, dass man da auch gründlich putzt. Also wenn man die Beine putzt.
Be careful when grooming the inside of the horse's legs. The so-called chestnuts are important for the horse and can be damaged when brushed with hard bristles. The dandy brush won't harm the chestnuts, but a harder brush like a currycomb can cause parts of the chestnuts to break off.
Das sollte man jetzt nicht machen, weil da kann es sein, dass dann einzelne Teile davon abbrechen. Mit der Kardetsche kann man dann die restlichen Staub.
The remaining dirt, like dust and grains of sand, can now be removed with the body brush.
Wegbürsten. Und damit nicht zu viel Dreck in der Bürste gelagert wird, streicht man diese dann immer wieder am Striegel ab.
Use the currycomb to clean the body brush and then beat the currycomb on the ground to remove the dirt from it.
Jetzt kommt Antons Lieblingsbürste, die
Schmutzbürste. Finally, the smoochy brush is used to groom the head. Notice how much your horse enjoys the treatment.
Ich werde lieber, als wenn man mit einer harten Bürste rangeht. Manche Pferde mögen es aber auch ganz gerne, wenn man.
Another way to groom the horse's head is with a furry glove. In general, when grooming the head, make sure that the brush or glove doesn't hit the horse in the eye. Also, pay special attention to the areas where the halter and snaffle are placed and clean around the ears, because horses do sweat there quite a lot.